I damn near pulled him off to your fucking nipples.
I'm gonna show you the damage you just did to me.
That shit stretched. Now that looks like a diaper. I think your diaper's full.
Yo, what up? Coming at you from R. Kelly's basement. It's Shane.
Oh shit, don't pee on me.
Morgan.
Yo, what's good?
And Colin.
Yeah.
So, word speaking of sex dungeons.
Speaking of the word of the day.
No, I'm sorry, I just have to address this. If you heard a belt buckle in the background, just don't worry about
exactly
it.
Exactly what it sounded like. No. For word of the day, this is important.
Speaking of word of the day.
Speaking. Alright, you can say it. I'll give it to you.
So, word of the day.
Alright, anyway. Back to what we were
word
talking
of the day
about.
Is amicable. Having a spirit or friendliness without serious disagreement or rancor.
Nobody understood.
Hit a like if you think that fucking word was terrible.
Hit a like.
Hit a like because anyone watches it.
Look, anyways.
Yeah.
Speaking of sex cults, right? Sex dungeons, sex cults.
Dab.
Right? I was thinking, maybe not a sex cult, but would you guys start a cult if you could? Colin first, would you start a cult?
Probably.
Why?
Why?
Like, what would your goal be as a cult leader?
Probably just take shit over.
Dude, here's what I was
like
thinking
the Mongolians.
No, here's what I was thinking about.
Essentially.
Maybe the Mongolians, think about this. I would just buy an island, right? Maybe with a credit card. And just pay it off with another credit card, because that's infinite money. Don't tell anybody that. Go buy an island. Go on the island. First, I have to wait till I'm old. You gotta be at least like 70. And I get like this big, long, gray beard, and I'm bald. Okay?
I think bald, but like some hair on the
side. Oh, yeah, yeah. Just long hair on the sides, frizzly, gray beard, bald on top. And I run this island, and all my like worshippers and followers were just communists. And we're just going to be a communist cult on an island. And we don't have to do anything. We can just live off the, you know, the fruit trees and stuff. And that's
out of the lamb.
That's all we're going to do. We're going to, like, I'll write a book, and that's it. That's my goal, right?
It's essential.
What do you think?
I feel like that's a good goal.
Well, why would you personally start a cult?
Make things the way I want them, you dig?
True.
Like how?
I don't know. I'd just be, like, the supreme dictator.
Would you, like...
So you just want to...
Would it be, like, a religion? Like, people are, like... Worship you, or like
worship
something.
Worship me. I'm definitely the god.
So like, and have people feed you grapes while like your servants like wash your feet.
Yeah,
you must just be a king.
Yeah,
here's
what I thought. Start a monarchy.
I just today realized because like I had like a different opinion on the best time to live. I changed mine. I think the best time to live would be like a medieval time. Tell me how tough that was during like medieval knights.
Yeah, but see, at the same time,
like a medieval knights, like kings and knights and stuff, that
would
have been
tough.
Yeah,
but who would you be in that situation? Like,
I would either want to be one of the knights or the king.
Definitely the king.
The king would be awesome, but just imagine, like, we were watching, what's that guy's name that pulls the sword out? Excalibur.
Yeah, but see, here's
King Arthur.
King Arthur.
Who's the other guy? Who's his knight guy?
Sir Lancelot.
I won't be Sir Lancelot.
That's really old, but see,
I don't care. Sir Lancelot is literally a beast. Like,
that's so
yeah, but at the same time, like, here's like here's worse. Like a really
he
good,
could be anybody. In a fight.
Here's a really good reason on like why that wouldn't be a good time to live.
Why'd he die?
You would die.
Medicine
like 10.
Was not as advanced, and a lot of their stuff was made out of like iron, so like it wasn't like stainless steel or anything like that. So it would rust. The minute you get either
that poke, is a huge problem.
The minute you get
so
either,
much rust.
The minute you either
teeming
get,
with rust.
Let me finish.
The minute I'm googling when stainless steel came out to fact check this.
The minute you get either poked, slashed, or stabbed by a rusty anything, sword, spear, knife, anything, you're in that case in our time period, you would need a tetanus shot. There were no tetanus shots back then. 1913
is when stainless steel.
Look up
so
Sir Lancelot.
He's true. I knew Sir Lancelot was a long time ago, but
yeah,
and he wasn't
so,
real. But if you're getting stabbed regardless, even if it's rust or not, you're probably still gonna die back then. Because
no, if you
a paper
if you,
cut, they're gonna amputate your arm.
At that point, if you get stabbed by anything and you manage to live through that, you might as well just off yourself at that point because you're gonna have
quality
a
of life.
You're gonna have a terrible time after that.
Like, it's crazy to think how bad medicine was to the fact where, like, you could get, like, a minor cut and it would just get infected and you just lose your whole body.
You're just dead.
Yeah. It's like game over.
Yeah. Really freaking common cold would kill him.
Can you imagine dying to the cold? You probably die to the cold today. Like, I feel bad.
Look,
I
almost died to the freaking flu. Come on, cut me some slack.
The flu's a little more justifiable.
Yeah, the flu's definitely more justifiable.
The cold, though, like, come on. That's late.
My personal opinion, I probably wouldn't start a cult. I'd probably just...
Look,
that's
if it was justifiable, and you would not get in trouble legally, you wouldn't start one?
No, and that's too much. That's too much responsibility.
It is being like
a if in some way, shape, or form, I could start a cult and I would just get a free motorcycle and like a cool leather jacket, I'd be down for it. But if
that's not a biker gang, you want to start a biker gang?
A biker gang cult. I would do that. But if that doesn't happen and I don't get like approached with that type of opportunity, it's definitely not going to happen.
If you have good enough ideas, you could literally start a cult. You know what I mean? Like if what you say sounds justifiable, like most murderers, but a lot, like Charles Manson was kind of a cult. Was Ted Bundy, wasn't he? Like, maybe not Ted Bundy. I know he was, like, good with his words. And he, like, persuaded people.
O.J. Simpson?
Charles Manson?
That whole thing was kind of a cult.
No.
What? How are you... Define how...
O.J. Simpson killed one person.
He killed two people.
Two people. That's not a cult.
More people. Define why you're saying Charles Manson and Ted Bundy, all these people.
Ted Bundy, I will agree. I definitely said wrong. But Charles Manson didn't never kill anybody. He had his followers kill people. So he was a cult leader.
Okay, that makes sense. But like,
yeah. Ted Bundy, I'd take that back.
Yeah, I was getting ready to say. Because that my reasoning behind that was because if you were talking about followers and stuff, O.J. Simpson had more followers trying to protect him and keep him out of jail than more people were trying to get him in jail.
I can get behind that. But anyways,
that was stupid.
Going back to if I started a cult, okay, by the island. Now with my new knowledge I learned today, I'm building a freaking castle. And we're going back to medieval times. And we're just going to run that hoe up. We're going to have boats. We're not going to have, like, no horses.
If you're going to build a castle, the proper word to use was wrench, not hoe.
Run that wrench up.
Damn straight.
No, for real. And we're going to have boats. Like, no horses, just boats. And we're going to, like, go to other islands and just raid them and
lots
stuff.
Lots of boats and wrenches.
So they're just going to be Vikings. I would kill to be a Viking.
Viking would be kind of
dude. Now, Viking, think about this. Sailing the seas and like
Vikings were around during night times, medieval times.
Yeah, uh-huh. Because they ever seen the show Last Kingdom on Netflix.
They were boat knights.
So
they were boat.
What was that really popular Viking? Eric something?
Leif Erikson.
Leif Erikson.
That's SpongeBob.
I don't know. He found America. He's the first person to land in America.
Oh, I thought that was fake because Leif Erikson did.
But what? Think about this: the original white people.
Yeah. North the Spain. OG white people.
Now people are like, now the we're like, mayonnaise is spicy, you know? We digress.
Yo, dude, we were white people in this period of time are so weak. They're so soft.
We were Norsemen who would be feared the second we touched freaking land. Anything. And now we're like,
yeah, white people, like manimals.
White people like, literally
want to eat meat.
White people literally cringe.
Spicy.
White people literally cringe if they touch curry. That's how soft we are.
We digress so
that's
much.
What we're starting a Viking cult.
We don't Viking we're scared cult. Of salt. We don't even season our potato salad anymore. It's just dry. There's no salt. There's no spice in that. It's dry.
If anything, if you're lucky, a little paprika. Then people are like, oh my god, that's,
water. That's even pushing it.
You know what?
Because people will down like 3 bottles of water at that point. Like, oh my god, why is this so spicy?
this
so hot.
This podcast right here is a cordial invite. Anybody who wants to be a Viking.
And then their names were so bad.
Oh yeah. You had your name and then like a title.
Yeah, so like the show, The Last Kingdom, Uthred the Godless. The tough ass name.
That is a tough name.
That is so pretty tough. Cool. And like, not to mention how like sick the ships were and how well equipped they were. Like they literally had like axes, swords, and knives just posted every single inch of like their ships. And
they just showed up like naked. Like, they were hard to wear any clothes. Like,
They had some cover. They had maybe a chest plate every now and then or something crazy.
We were watching, what's that guy's name that fought? Beowulf. Remember
Beowulf?
Beowulf was so tough.
We were watching that movie, and he was fighting Grendel, the big monster. Naked. Butt naked. Literally running around with his...
Swinging out.
His dong. Yeah, slapping his leg, fighting
in
his...
He's like molly-whopping Grendel.
In your main action, just beast mode on Grendel. Literally sicko mode on Grendel.
Then he kills his mom.
Yeah.
That's dude, crazy.
Like, it's crazy. I know that stuff was like make believe, or like those are stories.
That's also like I don't really know if that's like religion, but like, it's kind
of
like.
But like the possibilities of like situations and just like times of that. It's just like it's crazy.
Medieval was definitely the most like creative writing generation. Oh, yeah. Like dreamt up these huge dragons, like the knights fought these huge like beasts and monsters, and like today, like what's creative?
Stephen King's it.
Bro. I guess art has definitely changed. Those scenes were pretty awesome.
Yeah.
Like, to actually dream of a dragon, like, because dragon's not based on anything they've ever seen. They just imagine that.
Yeah, I know.
Like, that's kind of cool.
That's kind of cool, yeah. They just made that up.
Dude,
that
would...
Then now we got Donkey with a dragon making, like, Donkey Dragon.
No,
we...
Neither are. Yeah, Shrek cult.
Shrek cult. We're starting a Shrek cult. Hit us up at gmail.com if you want to join our Shrek cult.
It's at a Hotmail.
It's a... Hotmail. Oh, sorry, Hotmail. No, Gmail's more legit. It's abc123456@gmail.com. Hit us up. Join our call.
Did you just say my email address on air?
abc123.
Dude, I'm so sorry.
That's probably like 50 people's email addresses.
Yeah, I'm so sorry, I didn't mean to do that.
Nah, it'd definitely be cool to be like a Norseman, though. That'd be tough. It's like
that's like up. Skyrim, like...
Literally, Led Zeppelin wrote a song in
there. There's so many games and movies that just gas up medieval times so much to where it's like, I just want to be medieval.
Yeah, medieval times would be a cool era. If you're like, if you could like afford... You
know, and the wizards! Pastors. And the wizards of medieval time!
What?
Dude, no! Like, the
make-believe... The shoot fireballs
no,
at
like,
that was medieval?
Yes.
Wizards?
Wizards were during the medieval times.
They obviously like gas up wizard powers.
Well, of
yeah,
course.
No, I didn't realize just the thought of it. Because like he was talking about like, the dragons and stuff.
Alchemists
yeah.
and stuff.
Yeah, true. That is kind of tough.
He has to be like, oh, this goes with this. And...
Dude, alchemy, that's like... Isn't that like just turning random things into other things? Like,
it's basically... it's
like you like throw in like a pig's foot and all this stuff and next thing you know you got gold.
No, that's like... That's
alchemy.
Yeah, basically. It was trying to... I did a project on this. It was trying to create a new
metal or something. They did metal.
Like there was no science behind what they did. Like they like drank mercury.
Yeah, they're like, well, this is a good.
Yeah, thing. No, they were, and they were high on life. And
they're like, well, what? Why he died? And there's mercury just in his body. You cut him open, and he leaks mercury.
Dude, it's weird unusual. To think the things we used as remedies before.
Right.
Like, literally, they're like, oh, your foot hurts, why don't you drink a tube of mercury?
People would have headaches in the middle of times they drill a hole in their head. There would be
oh, pressure. Yeah.
Yeah, that'll fix him up real quick.
It's funny what we find is fact now and how far it was from then, but like 100 years from now, we're probably be looking back like, wow, right, these kids are really...
What about the first person to figure out that the urine isn't held in your testicles?
Like, who figured that out?
It's like, wow, I can't believe all that liquid came out of my nuts. It's like,
I mean, if we're really talking about this, who was the first person that figured out what milk was? Like, let's like, that's a age-old question that everybody wants.
Well, here's the thing.
Medieval times,
who was jerking on the cow titty and happened to have milk come out and drink it? Like, you really gotta be, like, on some serious drugs to even experiment.
It's probably something to do with the fact that, like, we always drink human milk.
Yeah,
but I don't know who was the first person to be like, let me drink another species milk.
They probably saw, like, a little cow drinking or something. Let me try that.
True, but isn't it just weird to think that we just, like, oh, let's not do our species. Let's go over to this species.
That's
true.
That is kind of
weird. And everyone knows milk is disgusting without... sweetener, like the milk we drink is not straight from the cow.
Oh, no.
It's like way fermented. Like no one generally drinks straight milk.
Those are just hard like that. That's a hard flex. You
that is a hard flex.
Yeah, no, that really is.
That's like binging in general.
It is in a way good for you. I'm, but at the same time, it is also bad because cows eat grass and stuff, but they also like can digest or ingest other like. Bacteria and stuff that can get in their milk, and it can also be bad for you.
I mean, so. they obviously clean it before they give it to us.
Yeah, but there's some like farmers and stuff that'll literally just yank on a cow's udder and just put it in their fridge right after. They'll fill up like a glass bottle or something. What else should we talk about? We could do the would you rather.
Yeah, which, would you rather? This kind of relates to the medieval stuff in a way too. So, Morgan earlier walks in the room and he's like, all right, guys, what was it? Would you rather
be... Would you rather be invincible but feel pain or not feel any pain but you're not invincible so you'll just die of whatever? Like,
so, like, to paint the picture, it's like, okay, you can get shot by a bullet. In one situation, you get shot by a bullet and you don't feel it, but it can kill you. Or you get shot by a bullet and you feel all the pain, but you don't die.
Yeah. And it's just... I don't know. I was thinking about it for a while. I was up late.
What was your response to that?
Honestly, I would probably just not feel any pain and just die whenever.
When the situation where you do feel the pain, do you live forever?
I would say you don't live forever.
I don't think physically possible. Pain can be so detrimental to your, like, just to your body that it'll cause you to die. So I don't think in that case you would.
I think
it would. It'd just be an immense amount of pain that would just like, it would bother you and hurt, but it wouldn't like, it wouldn't be so bad that it would kill you.
I think for the sake of this, we should say you can still die from like old age and cancer and stuff, okay, but the right. physical thing, like you getting stabbed wouldn't hurt, yeah. hurt you, getting shots. So you can't die from like murder, but you can okay. die. So
natural causes.
Yeah, natural causes. You could die yeah. of natural causes, but that's the only thing.
You get run over by a truck.
Yeah. So here's the thing.
You're gonna live through
Here's that. My take on that, right? If you can't feel pain, and let's pretend you were having a heart attack, you would not know. So you could still die. You know what I mean? That's why I would say I would rather be able to feel pain. Because, like, I wouldn't want to just, like, have a heart attack and not even realize I'm having a heart attack. You know what I mean? Like, there's people, there's, like, these documented cases of these people who can't feel pain. And they'll be walking around on broken legs and, like, all this stuff. And, like, they end up dying really early because they can't tell when something's wrong. You know what I mean? Like, yeah, pain's, like, the
your
biggest...
Your body feels pain for a reason.
Yeah, it's, like, the biggest red flag that something's going on. What do you think, Dakon?
I definitely agree with that statement because I wouldn't want to, like...
What would you choose out of the two of them?
Feel pain, but be invincible.
Yeah, see.
Is that what you think?
Mm-mm. I'd rather just not feel the pain. Just die of natural causes or whatever.
Just pain. How badass are
we? Rather take it.
This is the worst pain you felt.
Me?
Just anybody.
I'm breaking my collarbone.
Oh, that's a funny story.
Oh.
You should definitely see that story.
Well, we're doing powder puff football. Powder puff's when the boy football players teach the girl, like cheerleaders and like other girls, to play football. So we roll up, or I roll up before practice. We're just tossing a couple footballs around.
This is within probably 45 seconds of his mom dropping.
Oh, disclaimer, roll up means like show up, not actually roll up for all those, yeah, you know what I'm
so
talking
I
about.
Show
you know
up,
who I'm addressing.
So I show up.
There we go.
I don't actually roll up, and we're like walked up. I was walking.
He strutted.
Someone threw me a pass. I dove out for it. Just landed awkwardly on my collarbone, heard it pop. Like, I sat up and was like, damn, that hurt really bad. Not feeling too hot.
Yay Bacon comes running in.
My friend grabs me by both my shoulders, shakes me like, dude, you're right. I'm like, now this really hurts. Like, I'm not feeling good.
Yeah, he's literally shaking him by his collarbone.
He's like, yo, rake it up, man. I'm like, oh my God, like, I'm about to pass that.
Like, and Colin was like high on everything, like, from the adrenaline, like, and
yes,
just
I had
the
no
pain.
Idea what was going on. Because, like, obviously, I was like, in an immense amount of shock. I was like, this isn't happening right now. Like, I did not just hear my freaking shoulder area pop. And my mom. I had to go to my bag. I was, like, just carrying my arm by my side. I'm like, so I'm trying to act natural. I was, like, trying to walk past people without, like, sort of holding back, like, freaking
tears.
All this pain. And I had to call her. I was like, Mom, can you come pick me up real quick?
And she hadn't even left the parking lot yet. She turns around. She's like, oh, my God.
And she's like, her motherly instincts kicked in. And I was like, I got to go. We got to go to the hospital. And she's like, you all right? And I'm like, nope. Broke my collarbone.
Turned out, broke his collarbone.
Yeah. That was a really bad night.
What about you, Morgan?
You're gonna have to give me a minute. Let's start next with you.
Should I say my spleen story or my broken elbow story?
Which one? I feel like
most of my injuries are some dumb stuff.
I feel like you kept on playing basketball with your spleen injury.
It was definitely the most painful thing in my life though.
Let's say that one.
Alright, so we had these intramural championships going on. And the thing is, yeah, it was middle school. And, like, we had these at recess. You could, like, go and play different sports and, like, call you out to different areas and just kind of, like, a little tournament that went on during recess. And at the time, we were doing basketball. And my team made it all the way to the championship. And, like, they do, like, an A lunch versus B lunch championship, mm-hmm. something like that. And Colin was on the other team on B lunch.
No, I had no idea how to play basketball at that time.
Yeah, at the time, he had no idea. He was just on the team, like, and just got carried.
I got
chip.
Carried so hard.
So, my team, someone was doing jump ball. And he tells me, hey, go in this corner. And because I guess he was going to hit it to me. So he's like, all right, I'll go over there. And then I was starting heading towards the corner. And this other kid was like, yo, don't stand over there. Come back to the middle. So I was kind of like a little dead, like, I don't know what I'm going to do here. So I kind of stood between both spots. And then the kid who was hitting the jump ball hits it to the corner expecting me to be there. So I ran and tried to save it. I jump in midair, throw it behind my back, and then slam into the brick wall. And it's funny, the funny part about this was I was literally 3 inches from the pad against the wall to protect you. I was 3 inches away from that hit the wall, the brick. And instantly, like, I just felt the pain. I was like, oh my God, this is horrible. And it was like the first play of the game. So the whole rest of the game, I'm literally just hobbling around, like, and like he's saying about the whole shock and like adrenaline and all that stuff. I'm literally like, everything, every color just felt gray. Like, it was like, all the color felt gone. And he didn't really know basketball, so he's kind of just following me around, like, all right, I'm just going to cover you. So he's, like, talking to me. He's like, you came in. Like, you kind of, like, noticed a little bit. Something's up. Literally, I get the ball, and I ran the wrong way and scored on the wrong hoop. And Colin followed me and defended me the whole way. We looked like the most idiot kids. Whole entire school was watching. I'm going the wrong way, and Colin's trying to cover me from scoring in his hoop. Funniest thing ever. So it was after that, like, enough time goes by. I get called out of the game, and like, I was like, dude, I can't go back in. So I sat there. And, like, I'm trying to, like, hold back tears. I was, like, trying to be the tough kid, right? And I was 7th grade. So I'm, like, sitting there playing with my shoelaces because, like, tears are kind of, like, starting to come out. And kids are like, are you okay? And I'm like, yeah, I'm good. I did not look up from my shoelaces the entire game. Just, like, started looking at them. And my kids were like, yo, I saw you playing with your shoelaces. You good? Like, just, like, asking weird questions. And I finally get to class, and I was like, I'm really hurt. And like, I told some girl that, and she was like, dude, we got to take you to the office, blah, blah, blah. So I went to the nurse, and there's just like, do you have a concussion? Because, you know, school nurses, no qualifications. She's then, like, oh, you got a concussion.
Yeah, and then they called me down.
Oh, because they asked you, right? Yeah, because she was asking me, and I was like, I don't remember what happened. Because, like, I was so, like,
that's kind of a weird incident.
In the that moment that, like, I did not realize. Like, I just kind of forgot. And, like, it was weird.
Ran into a wall. Like.
Yeah, and, like, I started running into the wall. She said, do you hit your head? I was like, I don't remember.
And, it's
like,
it's kind of like, it's kind of like when you're, like, you're just playing around and, like, you're playing football or something and you're just, like, having so much fun and you're just so in the moment that, like, you'll cut your leg and something and maybe, like, after the moment's over and, like, you're kind of recollecting yourself, you'll finally notice it and just be like, what the heck happened?
Yeah, so anyways, the nurse kind of, like, dismisses me and she's like, oh, you probably just, you got hit your head pretty hard. I'll send you off to lunch or whatever. And that day we had an assembly. So Colin got called down because I guess I told her Colin was with me.
Yeah.
And she asked you, what'd she ask you?
She's asked, oh, did you see what happened? I'm like, yeah, you ran into a wall. That's about it.
And then so, anyways, we end up going to the assembly and it's like minute to win it. Like, it's like this assembly that we do every year in middle school where people like gotta do the minute to win it games or whatever. So a bunch of my friends thought it'd be funny to put a bunch of tickets with my name in them on something. Like, I didn't even know about this like days before they did that. So then I get called as one of the people to do it. And I'm literally, like, doing this, like, weird thing where I'm, like, football snapping toilet paper rolls into a thing. And I'm, like, hunched over, like, with my spleen hurting, doing all that stuff. And it was just horrible. So, anyways, I toughed that out or whatever throughout the day. And I finally went, like, I'm a pickup. So, my mom, like, picked me up and took me home. And I was, like, I don't feel good. And she was, like, are you okay? And I was, like, I don't know. I'm just going to lay down. And she, like, had her, like, motherly instinct or whatever, took me to the hospital. And the first one we went to, the lady was, like, this is a big buff Russian lady, right? And she walks in and she's like, are you okay? I was like, I don't know, like, blah, 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 blah. I said the whole story. And then she was like, I touched spleen now. Reached, like, through my skin, it felt like, under my ribs and, like, tickled it. And she was like, does that hurt? And I was like, no. Because, like, I was just that kid that would never admit I was hurt. And then she was like, I think you just bruised your lung and broke your rib. She, like, did an x-ray and, like, had a broken rib or whatever. So I go home, and I'm, like, still hurting. My mom's like, you definitely lied about how much that hurt. And then she took me to another hospital, and they gave me a CT scan. Mm-hmm. And the lady's like, oh, you're definitely – she was like, how much does it hurt? Scale 1 to 10, all this. And I was like, 3. And, like, because I'm just that kid.
Bluff.
I bluff. So, anyways, she's like, okay, well, this is probably fine. I'm going to do a CT scan just for a measure. You're probably fine. She comes back, like, after we do the CT scan. She's like, well, you lacerated your spleen, and you have a broken rib and a bruised lung. And I was like – oh. So she was like, yeah, we're going to have to take you to an ambulance to the other hospital now. And I was at that point, I was just mad. I was like, are you kidding me? So these like two men come over with like a stretcher and they're like, get on this. And they're like, hey, do you want us to pick you up? And I was like, nah, man, I got it. So I stood up and sat on it. And they're like, you seem pretty fine for that. And I was like, dude, I was just mad. Like, I feel like the anger is just feeling.
He's just trying to flex on everybody with his high pain tolerance, you know?
No, I was literally, it wasn't even pain tolerance. I was just mad. I was like butthurt that this lady, like, she didn't lie to me, but I had this false sense of hope that I was fine. I had to stay in the hospital for like 3 days.
Well, you turned her pain to 3.
It was definitely my fault, true, but I was just mad that I had to stay.
Thank God your mom was like, oh, let me take him to another hospital.
I know, like, something bad could have happened.
Yeah.
What's your pain?
Damn. Worst pain? This is kind of a story, but it'll all come together. So it was rec football. It wasn't anything too serious.
It was pretty serious.
It was pretty serious.
Was it the last year? No, it wasn't the last year. It was the year before, and we're at an away game, and I'm playing with like all older kids and stuff. A lot of kids that were either a grade or two above us, and. We're just playing a regular football game against another team. I think it was in South Dorchester, and It was pretty serious because we had a pretty good record. We were at the time we were 9-0, and that game would have qualified us.
I was on that team with you.
No, I don't think so. It was with like Trey Pender and Garrett Murray.
Oh, did you get sent up a team?
Actually, no. Yeah, we're going to play. No, that wasn't. It was the same team. It was the same team with like Noah Skinner and
It doesn't matter.
What?
So what happened?
So we're playing, and that at that point in my football career, that was like one of the only times that like I was good enough to play, be a starting position.
Here's a big body.
Yeah, at that time in my life, compared to everyone else, I was a pretty big body. Like the position I was playing, which was
yeah, Morgan hit puberty at like 3.
Yeah, no, I was pretty built for like a 14-15 year old, and what was it? I was playing tight end. I think it was tight end on offense, and I think I was playing linebacker on defense, and we were doing pretty good. We were up 2 touchdowns against the team. And the quarterback decided to do a lateral back, and the running back came to my side when I was playing outside linebacker, and he ran towards the edge of the edge of the sideline, and I just caught him, wrapped him up, and like I was like maybe like a foot taller than this kid, and like it took no effort to put him down on the ground. I basically picked him up like mid sprint and just threw him on the ground. But somehow I don't really know who was behind me. I don't know how this happened, but just with all the force and how fast I was running, something hit my legs or I just caught my own foot and I just flew. I flew a couple feet off to the side near our where our players sit if they're not in the game, and I tumbled for a couple seconds and I was kind of like rolling. Trying to recover, and I get up, and just all of a sudden, there's just a bunch of adrenaline in my system, and it's just a shooting pain, throbbing pain, just all out from about a little above my wrist all the way down to my fingertips. And I'm sitting there, I'm just grabbing my hand, I'm like, I'm hyperventilating and stuff. I'm just in so much shock at that point. I'm not sure what I did, and I'm breathing a lot. And the coach is like telling me, he's like, good play, you need to do this, this, and this. And he's trying to talk to me, and I just can't. I couldn't listen to him. I was just in so much pain. And I'm sitting there. I'm like, Coach, this isn't all right. I'm not okay. Something's wrong. And luckily, on that team, there was a couple moms there that were...
nurses?
Quote-unquote, registered nurses. Which, they were definitely sicing on that one. And you'll figure out why in a minute. They were looking at my wrist and, like... Instantly, they could tell that I had broken it because I had the outside part of my wrist, right where that like little bone sticks out, right on the part of your wrist on the outside. It was just completely like it was sticking out from my wrist. It was just not
the bone was out.
That it was like a little hook sticking out right on the edge of my wrist, and they could tell instantly that I had broke it. And I was like. Me being me and like me being in the position I was like no, I gotta go back in, like just wrap it up real quick. And they're like, no, you can't play, like you'll make it a lot worse. And so we didn't really have like any real first aid kits for stuff like this, but we did have a lot of crappy leftover equipment for like anybody that broke something or tore something, from like their shoulder pads to like to their knee pads or anything like that. So one of the registered nurses, I'm not going to name anybody's mom because I'm just going to keep that information to myself. But she seemed like she was the most qualified nurse or qualified person to be doing this to me. She decided to take a full roll of athletic tape and take a knee pad and put the knee pad on top of my wrist and tape it down as tight as she could. And just keep it straight. Basically trying to like make a makeshift cast just to splint it up to make sure I don't bend it or I can't bend it. And it at that point it's just like it's not doing anything. My wrist is just in so much pain. I at that point I was thinking, I was like, I'm probably gonna just gonna try to stick it out for the rest of the game. Cause I didn't wanna leave. I didn't wanna seem like a pussy. So I sit on the bench and I'm in a lot of pain, so I am crying. And all the cheerleaders, like, I was friends with the majority of them. Like, we hung out outside of a...
No flex.
No flex intended on that one. But, like, I was friends with the majority of them, and they kept walking up to me asking me what happened, and I couldn't even tell them because I had no idea. They said the mom said that I broke my wrist, but, like, I just really couldn't tell. I couldn't see what she was seeing. And at that point when I broke my wrist, it was maybe the beginning of the third quarter. So, like, the game was almost done. We end up winning the game, and everybody goes to the end zone and huddles up, and the coach is talking to us and telling us, like, how good we did and, like, how good of a game it was, and, like, preparations for, like, the next game and how practice is gonna be. And I'm talking to my mom, and I'm telling her, I'm like, this isn't right, like, something, like, I need to go to the hospital. And the mom was also suggesting that I should go to the hospital too, because of how my entire wrist and hand and fingertips were all white, purple, and, like, blue. They were, everything on my wrist down to my fingertips was just swollen. Nothing was red, nothing was, like, a tan color. It was just purple and blue. It looked really bad. And so we drive to an urgent care. It's, like, basically, like, a child hospital. And already off the bat, it takes me, like, an hour just for a doctor to see me. And I get in, and he just takes one glance at my wrist, and just, he's like, you need to take that off right now. And I was like, why? He was like, you'll figure it out in a minute. And he sends me back into the back room where the x-ray machine is. He takes x-rays of my wrist, and he comes back out. He brings the x-rays with him and puts them up on a little light board. And he's telling me that I broke my wrist in five different places and fractured it in three. And I had created a bone spur within my within the inside part of my wrist that was jabbing at my hand. And at the he never fully answered the question on why he wanted me to take the tape and the knee pad off so bad. So before I left, I asked him, I was like, why did you want me to take it off as soon as possible? He was like, oh, it was cutting off your circulation. Like, your entire hand was about to just, we were going to have to amputate it if you didn't take it off. So the registered nurse, the quote unquote registered nurse, did that to me. And nearly had my wrist to my the fingertips amputated. I almost
did. You imagine Morgan had a nub?
I just had a nub at 14 years old. I almost had a nub.
If this story played out any differently, Morgan would be freaking Captain Hook. Right. Anyways, it's been TWB with Colin, with Morgan, and with I.
Colin
still in R. Kelly's basement. Morgan's favorite word.
Getting musty down here.
Cunt. It's getting musty, really dusty. Dusty. Musty, dusty, crusty. It's really crusty down here. Dusty, crusty. And R. Kelly, stop.
TWB, it stands for...
Musty.